Hey everyone, it's Sav and the old man. How are you? We're going to be trying out. This is what we're going to be playing this year. We've just decided that we're playing the Rogue Pro, and I'm going to be having mine set up on a True Temper shaft, and Sav's
got the Tensei AV White.
She's doing on
75 grams.
Wow, are you ever smoking that?
It
is
good.
So consistent.
Yeah.
The side spin is very minimal on it. I can't wait for you guys to see her hit it. So we're going to be showing you why you're going to be getting 30 yards more than what you have now. If all of you are feeling that you're not getting the yardage that you deserve, it's most likely in your grip, and which means that it's not allowing you the ability to get all the way through the ball. So while I'm chit-chatting with you, Sav's going to be demonstrating her grip, which is a super hammering grip. And I'll be demonstrating a really cool breakthrough that I had with one of my students that had some rotator cuff issues, really struggling to get that rotation through the shot. So we went with a neutral grip and super closed club face. And once he got past that super closed club face, and realized a very important thing, that dynamically, he ended up looking like her. And this very, you know, not a very big person is now hitting 7-irons, smoking them at 175 when he was struggling to make 140 yards with them. So that could be you, and you really don't want to miss this show. And Sav, a very important message.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, ring the bell, give us a thumbs up.
Yeah, do all the good stuff. You know what to do. You know, subscribe to our channel. Become members of our family. We really appreciate that. To begin, Sav, I want you to face the camera and show us that magnificent strong grip. Look at those beautiful nails you got here, too.
Thank you. They're happy nails.
They're happy nails, huh? So if we look at how she's doing that, if I was hammering straight down, I would have what we call a neutral grip. It would be neutral looking. But then when I get ready to hammer towards the target, look what we got here. Sav and Dad looking alike, right? So this is allowing me to drive in that direction. So anatomically, the radius and ulna are stacked this way. This is going to give me some awesome compression. If I want to take that compression to the target, I'm going to turn it this way, and now I've got this incredible power hammering position that's going to allow me to go this way. And you notice how my lead shoulder is higher than my left shoulder, my trail shoulder. And notice how there's a tilt in my spine from the head all the way down to the tailbone. And it looks like I got a little more weight on that lead side. Many of you have been asking, you know, the secret to Sav's success about that lead, leaning into that lead side. It's just Sav getting ready to crush a nail in that direction toward the target, right? So if you were to set up like you're going to hammer that as a nail in that direction. Yeah, sorry about that. It was crooked. So take a backswing and stop. Come on down in slow motion. Show me how you're going to drive that nail toward the target. Excellent. So we are collecting the nail from where it is and driving the nail into the direction we want it to go. And after we finish driving, there's going to be a natural release of that anatomy, and that's where you want to make sure you get with our premium channel. We just posted 4 incredible videos, add-ons to the release pattern. So, but today it's all about this, and already this is going to get you some awesome stuff, okay? So let's look at Sav hit a nice little par 3 here. All right. Let's go. So that was a lovely, nice miss, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So just a little fin off the bottom of the club, but beautiful pattern coming in there. Oh, that was crushed.
Yeah.
And look at the consistency you're getting out of that club. Oh my.
It just feels so good. Like, this is probably the best iron shaft setup I've had.
We've been, don't worry about the bottom right corner.
It's that's just a glitch.
It's been kind of glitching. You've been coming through at about 3 degrees toe up with that club. Mm-hmm. And I don't want to touch that because it's getting you some really awesome results. But look at your angle of attack. It's like 10 degrees down, 9 from the inside. I mean, the carry on that was 180. It's a little downhill, but your carry has been consistently 175 with that 7-iron.
Yeah.
And the pro models are not as beefy as the regular, you know, the other models. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, the results have been absolutely fantastic. So one thing I want to show everyone is at the top of the backswing. Go to the top of your backswing and stop. Because that grip is nice and strong, she's getting this awesome hinge on what we call the anatomical snuff boxes. Right here is a nice little cavity above your wrist. This is what you need to truly hammer down with.
Yeah.
And when she allows that to set at the top of the backswing, go ahead and set up. Top of backswing and stop. Notice the club face is facing the sky right here. Now, when you get that, imagine you're going to swing one toward the camera. Keep coming. There you go. Appreciate that. Now, look at how the club is really settled in underneath this index finger. The anatomy of her hands and her wrists is spot on spectacular. But what you're going to feel is when the toe of the club is facing the sky, it feels a little heavier in your hands. And it's going to feel very strange to you, right? So this feels very natural to you after a while. But don't allow that to, you know, to prevent you from doing your thing, because you're still going to be able to whip the snot out of it, right? Yeah. So let me look. And I'll show you a different version of what you can do, right? Because when you do face the camera one more time, Sav, take that grip. So for many of you, when you grip it this way, you'll notice, so here's me with a neutral grip and a face that's over 45 degrees closed. That's what my student does. And so if I try to square that up, this gives a lot of tension here in my forearm. And it creates a lot of torque and tension in there that you may not want to have in your swing. Mm. You don't feel tension there, do you?
No.
So when you get behind the ball, this feels very natural and it still feels quite relaxed. And it's something that many of you won't have. She's just had that ever since she was about yay big, right?
Yeah.
A little bug. So if I go to my grip and club that's neutral and very closed, and I take a backswing, and now I'm coming back down and I'm going towards you, Sav. Notice how the hands come through first. Mm-hmm. Doesn't that look like you?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So I have a square club face with a very strong looking grip. But I went from hammering down, see how the face is pointed straight down, I can hammer down, to hammer through. So I'll take my normal backswing. And then I'm going to go toward the target. You'll see Rory McIlroy, Tommy Fleetwood. They start off pretty level. And then when they get to the top of the swing, they're going to tilt this way because they're going towards the target. Mm-hmm. That's where the money is. That's where the target is. So I'm leading with my hands like every other discipline in the book. When you're going fishing, you lead with the hands. When you're cutting a bamboo shoot with a machete, you never lead with the blade. That would be very devastating. You always lead with the hands. So I've got a nice closed face with my normal neutral grip. And all of you are going to be looking down at that and you're going to think, this guy's nuts, right? And then you're going to go, okay, I'm going to send that ball out to the target. And then you're going to see the ball fly out very straight. If it hooks a few times, that's a great thing. Because if it starts to hook for you, then you won't have any reservations about sending the ball out to the right because you know it's going to come back. So every time you look down at your grip and you say, hey, every time I have that, it always curves to the left. So now you can start that ball out to the right and you know it's going to come back. And that's really important for all of you who think you're coming over the top. But if you've got a neutral grip and a square face, and now you're going towards the target, well, you could try to get that back with the wrist. It's going to be really, really difficult for you to do. And then you're going to have to do the rest with the body. Now you're over the top.
Yeah.
And that's as simple as that. So notice, because Sav dynamically has a grip that's going to allow her to have a beautiful little draw, and she can fade, power fade that sucker at will, then she never struggles with delivering the shot a little bit to the left of that intermediate point.
Yeah.
And she gets this beautiful draw to come in. I mean, look at that ball flight. We got a 2-yard draw. So if I had a neutral grip with a square face, I'm going to aim just a little bit to the left because I'm going to come in with a fade on this one. It's a perfect draw for you, but I'm going to hit a fade.
Yeah.
And if it's a little too open, I'm going to try and get to the target here. Goodbye.
See you never.
So this is what it's going to feel like for all of you with a neutral grip. And you're thinking, how do I get this? I gotta learn how to square it up. I got to learn how to come more from the inside. I got to flatten out. I got to do all these things. Well, the reason why you're over the top in the first place is because that gosh darn club face is just too open.
Yeah.
Right? So now if I close it, I go neutral grip, close face. And I'm going to start this to the left of the intermediate point. So notice the first time when I had square face, neutral grip, look at the top of my backswing. When my wrists are hinging just like Sav, notice how the toe of the club is drooping toward the ground.
Yeah.
It's going to be really tough to get to the target from there. So I close a face, neutral grip. Now when I go to the top of the swing and I allow him to hinge, see the club face now?
Yeah, it's way better.
So that club face is now at least square to slightly closed. So square to slightly closed. And then we're going to go a little fade with that. Here we go. Now, did you hear the compression on that already?
Yeah.
That was a lot better. Now it's in play.
Yeah.
I'm not in the bush anymore. I got the members bounce too. And we got a nice carry of 181 yards instead of, what was my carry on the previous one? And that's typically what we're going to get here. If I go to the table, we look at there, 160 versus 181.
Yeah.
So that is a very typical situation. So if I go close neutral, and then I can square it up, then I got my hammer. We're going to come in with a nice little fade. There it is.
Nice.
Look at that puppy.
Oh, that was long too.
My goodness, look at that. There it is in a nutshell. This is what you need to do with your grip club relationship. This is what's going to allow you to make it through to the target. Now, just a couple of last little things. Where should peak speed be in your swing? Most of you are thinking it's at the bottom of the swing. You're going to go about there. It's actually there, out into the picture. We're collecting the ball from where it is, and we're releasing the ball out to where it's going. We just came out with this beautiful video on through the ball. You're going to see on the thumbnail two T's. Mm-hmm. You did a great job with that thumbnail, by the way, Sav.
Thank you.
And we're moving through the T's, trying to make them spin like tabletop spinners. Imagine I had this big globe in front of me, this planet that mm-hmm. usually is on that stem, and I want to make it spin. I'm collecting it from here and releasing it out there. One of the guys that you want to watch is called Joaquin Niemann. He's the guy that's the most through the ball that you'll see on the PGA Tour and demonstrates this to a T. So enjoy that. Get cracking with your new grip and club relationship, and we'll see you 30 yards further down the fairway. All the best.